So now I would like to give you some short demos with a couple of different runbooks explaining you how to work with those activities in a real environment with real runbooks. Okay, first of all, I would like to show you how to use the query WMI activity. So I've created a simple runbook that has three activities. First of all, the starting point is again a monitor date time activity that is defined to run every 5 seconds. The next one is the query WMI activity itself, and I've defined my remote server, which is called VMM01. I've defined the namespace that I'm going to use for the WMI query, and then the query itself called select caption from Win32 operating system. I'm done with that query. So it asked me if I would like to check out that runbook. I'm not going to change anything here. It's done already, and then I'm using the send platform event, which is part of the notification foundation object part, and I'm going to write an information type notification to the platform. I've added a summary WMI output, and then I'm using a published data. So I'm going to remove that here and show you how I've done that one. So I'm going right click, subscribe, publish data, and then I have the WMI query result as a string, and I'm using that one pretty straightforward. So, and I'm done here. I'm able to check in that runbook, and I'm starting that. It will immediately create one instance. So in the real-time log, you see immediately an instance is there. It was created by the runbook server, and you see the output already. So it runs through all the three activities. And the platform events, you'll find them here at the events section, and it's already running a couple of times, and you see the summary WMI output, the caption, it's Microsoft Windows Server 2012 Data Center, and you see the type is information, everything that we have defined in that event, send platform event activity. So that's a pretty simple example on how to use query WMI activity. So another example of a runbook where I'd like to show you a couple of different complex activities that we've discussed now is the one that I called web service here. So again, a monitor date time activity here. It will run every 20 seconds. Okay, I will go and check out that runbook first. Then I've used the query database activity where I have defined the connection to a database. This time I'm using a SQL server using Windows authentication. I have defined my server name. This is SQL01. My initial catalog, that's the database name, that's TestDB. I've defined also my security account for that, and then in the details pane or details tab, I've defined my query select top one star from DBO country city. That actually, that table is pretty easy. It just has got two columns. One is a country column and one is a city column. So I have there a couple of entries with cities in specific countries. And from there, it goes directly to the invoke web service activity. Double click here. I'm going to use a global available web service with that URL. So I've defined the WSDL URL of that web service. So you can just grab that URL, paste it to your browser, and you will see the description file of that web service. And if you double click on that button here, you will get all the methods that are available. Actually, there are only two here, and I'm using the getWeather method of that web service. And then if you click on the format hint button down here, it will add this XML request payload, and the only thing you have to do is add your parameters you have to pass into that method. So getWeather defines two input parameters, city name and country name, and I'm going to use those from the database. So if I click on format hint, I will get city name, string, country name, and I just have to replace those strings with real values. So either I can, of course, define a hard-coded city name and country name here, but I would like to use those from the database. So I'm replacing those. So for the city name, I'm going to use right-click some published data here. So I'm going to the query database activity. So we're going to use the full line as a string. That's actually the published data for every record. So if the query database returns three records, I will get three full lines with the records, with all the columns separated by semicolons. So I'm going to use that here. But I only need the city name here, so I have to use some string manipulation function that's called field. The first parameter of that is the full line that I'm getting back from the database, and then I have to define what is the separator for each of the columns here, and then which field I want to use here. So I would like to use field number, I would like to use field number 2, because field number 1 is an ID, number 2 is the city name, and number 3 is the country name. So again, I'm using published data here, same way as before, using the full line here, and this time I'm also using the field function here, and I forgot the square bracket here, and this is number 3 of that row. So that's it. With that, I use published data from the query database activity and push that as a parameters to the web service. So I'm now done with that. Click on finish. So this invoke web service call will give me some reply XML response back, and I'm going to use the query XML activity here using the XML response from the invoke web service, and then I'm defining my XPath query here, and I'm just grabbing the element get better result wherever it is in that XML. And then I'm adding that to a file. So I'm using the append line. I'm defining an XML message, and the file encoding is set to auto. And then as a text, I'm using the query result, also published data. So I'm able to show you that here without clicking on OK. I'm using the query result from the query XML response activity. And this will just add that part of that XML response from the web service and write that to that file here defined here in the file text box. So with that, I'm able to test that. I'm going ahead and check in that file, that runbook. So I'm done with the check-in, and I'm going ahead and click on run. And if we go to the log, we will immediately see one instance coming up, and so now it will run through all the activities. First, we'll query the database. In this case, we have defined the query as top one, so it will only return one row with a city and a country, and it will go with that city and country. It will go to the web service and call that web service. And it will get back some XML response, and I'm going to create a file there. So we see that's done already. Everything was a success. And if we now go to the folder that I've defined, C web service message, you will see a weather.xml file which was recently created. If we are going to open that with Notepad, you'll see the XML response that was part of that web service, what was published by the web service with the information we passed in from the database. So one quick change here that you're able to see that. So query database, I'm just removing the top one from the query, so we will get all the data that's in that database. I need to check out that. So I've done the changes. Just double check that. So it selects start from country city table. Check in again. And I'm going to move away and remove the weather XML file. So, and we're going to run that guy again back to the log file. See the new instance coming up now, and waiting a couple of seconds. Now it takes a little longer because it has to call the invoke web service a couple of times. So query database doesn't return one row, but it will return a couple of rows. Not quite sure about the count, but I guess it will be 5 to 6 rows in there. And let's see. That one is not the one from now. It was the one when I pressed the stopped button. So here is the new one. And what you see is that query database was run once, but then it calls the web service, invoke web service activities a couple of times. So for each row of the query database, it called the invoke web service here, and again query XML response. So it will query the XML for every call to the web service, and also add that to the file a couple of times. So if we, let's stop that first. I need to close that here, stop that here. And then if we go to the message, open the weather XML file again using Notepad, you'll see the different locations. So this one is Alice Springs in Australia. There is Rockhampton Airport in Australia, Adelaide Airport, and all those cities that are defined in the database. So with that, I showed you a couple of different complex activities that we've discussed, and I hope you understand the different ideas behind those activities and how to use them. So as a summary, I think I've talked a little bit about the different foundation objects that are most likely from interest if you think about more complex scenarios you'd like to tackle with Orchestrator, how those are supported, which options you've got with them, what are the scripting options you have with Orchestrator and the scripting activity, and how published data will be used in each of those activity, which is one of the most important parts. So how every activity will publish data to the data bus, and how you can grab that data from the data bus and again work with that throughout your scenario and your workflows. So at the end, again, I would like to give you some more links on where you can find more information about Microsoft software and how to do another technical training and find more information on that. So first of all, it's the TechNet Eval Center, which you find on TechNetMicrosoft.com/EvalCenter, where you can find trial versions that you can download for free from Microsoft software. Then we have the IT Champs, which is on TechNetMicrosoft.com/GlobalITChamps, where you will find a lot of technical trainings, events for IT professional. And last but not least, the Microsoft Virtual Academy, which offers really technical trainings for free on Microsoft products as well, which is on MicrosoftVirtualAcademy.com. With that, thank you very much for your time, and see you soon on another session on Orchestrator 2012 on Microsoft Virtual Academy. Thank you.